Hello, friends. How are you doing? I hope you're doing very well. And thank you once again to all of you for coming here and trying to be better at aptitude one video at a time. In this video, we continue with the time and work. And here we are going to look at the joining and leaving of people, but probably of more than one people. Okay, more than one person joins or leaves the work to be done, and so how does it impact the total time taken? Let us look at this question. A and A, B, C are building a home. A and B together can build it in 10 days, B and C in 15 days, and C and A in 20 days. For the first 6 days, everyone works together, and then they had a fight, and A leaves. Then B and C work for 4 more days, okay? And then there is another fight, and B leaves. How long will C take to complete the home? So, after, so we look at two different outcomes. One is if only C was working, C for the entire home, if the question was that, we will solve. Or from this day, that when B leaves, how many more days does C take? Okay, we look at both. If C was working alone from the beginning, how many days does he take? We'll find. And if B leaves, how many more days from there does C take to finish the home? We can find both. How long will C take to complete the home? If the question was how long will C take to complete the home after B leaves, we'll find that out, or we'll find out how long will B take to complete the home working alone. So it depends on how the question is formed after this. Now A plus B, A and B in one day can do 1 by 10th of the work. B and C in one day can do 1 by 15th of the work. C and A in one day can do 1 by 20th of the work. Now, if I add all of this, I get A plus B plus B plus C plus C plus A is equal to 1 by 10 plus 1 by 15 plus 1 by 20. I see A, B, C on the left-hand side is repeated twice, so I do 2 times A plus B plus C is equal to this. So our LCM would be 60. 6 plus 4 plus 3. So A plus B plus C is 10, 13 in the numerator, 13 by 120. So A plus B plus C in one day will do 13 by 120th of the work. But what happens? They were working for 6 days. So in 6 days, how much of the work is done? 6 days, all three are working. In one day, they do 13 by 120. In 6 days, they will do 13 by 120 into 6. So they will do 13 by 20th of the work. Okay, one day they are doing. So how do I do? A plus B, B plus C, and C plus A I have. I add all of this, so I get 2 times of A plus B plus C is equal to 13 by 60. So A plus B plus C is 13 by 120. So A plus B plus C in one day they do 13 by 120th of the work. In 6 days they do 6 into 13 by 120, which is 13 by 20th of the work. In 6 days they do this. Now A leaves. Now B and C work for 4 more days. So B and C in one day they do 1 by 15th of the work. After the 6th day, only B and C is working for 4 days. In 4 days, they finish 4 by 15th of the work. The next 4 days. Why? Because A is not there. B and C can do 1 by 15th in the work. In 4 days, they do 4 into 1 by 15. So 4 by 15th of the work is done. So how much of the work is left? For 6 days, so work is considered when one is complete. In first 6 days, they do 13 by 20. Next 4 days, they do 4 by 15. So this much of the work is left. So my LCM is 60. 60 minus 13 into 3, which is 39, minus 4 into 4, minus 16. Okay. This is 55 by 60. Sorry, this is 5 by 60. Becomes 1 by 12. Okay, this is 60, 39 and 16 is 55. 60 minus 55, 5 by 60 becomes 1 by 12. So 1 by 12th of the work is left. 1 by 12th of the work is left. So how do I, let me insert a blank slide. If you feel okay, or let me see if I can do that here. Can I erase something? We've gotten 13 by 120. Let me just erase this. Make some space. So you know, a plus b plus c is 1 by 120. That is what we have gotten here. Let me just write that here. A plus b plus c is 1 by 120. Okay. Now we have 1 by 12th of the error, which is pending. So pending work is this much, 1 by 12. From these two equations, I get, if I add those, I get 2c plus a plus b is equal to 1 by 15 plus 1 by 20. But a plus b I know from here is 1 by 10. So I write that 2c plus 1 by 10 is equal to 1 by 15 plus 1 by 20. So 2c is, if I take the LCM, 60. 1 by 15 plus 1 by 20 minus 1 by 10. Okay, so if I take 60, I get 4 plus 3 minus 6. Because 1 by 10 becomes minus 1 by 10. So this is 7 minus 6, 1 by 60. 2c is equal to 1 by 60. C is equal to 1 by 120. Okay, so C will do 1 by 120th of the work in one day. He has to do 1 by 12th of the work. One day. Okay, so to complete the work, so to complete 1 units of work, C takes 120 days. To complete 1 by 12th of the work, C takes how many days? Okay, so this is all. If the question was how long will C take to complete the work working alone from beginning, it is this 120 days. Here, to complete the work, it takes 120 days. To complete 1/12 of the work, it takes 120 into 1 by 12, it takes 10 days. So if your question was how long will C take to complete the entire house working alone, it is 120 days. How long will C take to complete the home after B leaves is 10 more days. Okay, so what did we do? We said A plus B is 1 by 10 because of the first three statements. A and B together can build a house, and A plus B is 1 by 10. B plus C is 1 by 15 and C plus A is 1 by 20. We added that. We got 2 into A plus B plus C is 1 by 60. We got A plus B plus C is 1 by 120. Meaning all three people working will finish 1 by 120th of the work in one day. They are working for 6 days. So I did 13 by 120 into 6. So I get 13 by 20th of the work. Okay, I did 13 by 120th of the work. Then in the next 4 days, A leaves, so B and C together can finish 1 by 15th of the work in one day. So in 4 days, you do 4 by 15. So 13 by 20th of the work is done, 4 by 15th of the work is done when B leaves. So how much work is left? I subtract that from 1. I get 1 by 12. So 1 by 12th of the work is left. Then from equations 2 and 3, we get C is equal to 1 by 120. Okay, see, that is done here. I add equation 2 and 3, and in A plus B, I substitute this value from equation 1. I get C as 1 by 120. Meaning, to complete the entire work, C takes 120 days. To complete 1/12 of the work, C takes 10 days. Okay. So we got an 120 if C was working alone from the beginning. 10 if the number of days is asked after B leaves. Let us look at another method to solve this question. Right? So A plus B. For the first 6 days, how do we take? If I say A plus B is 1 day work and B plus C is 1 day and C plus A is 1 day. If I add all of this, how many days is it being counted as? So here I have A is 1 day work. So this effectively becomes 2 times A plus B plus C. Correct? Right, A plus B plus B plus C plus C plus A. 2 times A plus B plus C is 1 day work. Now, if I have to get the work done in 6 days, I have to multiply each only by 3. If I multiply by 3, I will get 3A plus 3B's. 3 times A is 1 day work. 3 times B is 1 day work. Plus 3 times B is 1 day work. Plus 3 times C is 1 day work. Plus 3 times C is 1 day work, plus 3 times A is 1 day work, becomes 6 times so of A plus B plus C. So I multiply by 3. If I multiply by 6, will become 6 time a1 dy plus 6 time b1 dy plus if then it will be 6 plus 6 it will be 12 times a1 dy. Again I repeat, a plus b1 dy plus b plus c1 dy plus c plus a1 dy. I know. Now we have to calculate how much they finish in 6 days. If I multiply by 6, I will get a multiplied by 6 in two places. So c will become 6a here, 6a here, it become 6b here, 6b here, and 6c here, 6c here. It will become 12a plus 12b plus 12c. No, we need 6a plus 6b plus 6c. If I multiply by 3, it will become 3a, 3b, then again 3b, 3c, 3c, 3a. So adding all of this, it will become 6 times a plus b plus c is 1 day work. So that is done. But how do I simplify that? I will keep it as it is. 3 times a plus b is 1 day work. I expanded it to show that it is 6 times. Plus 3 times b plus c is 1 day work. Plus 3 times c plus c is 1 day work. But the next 4 days, b and c work. Only b and c work. Which means only this works for 4 more days. Okay. So we'll have the equation modifies to 3 times a plus b plus 7, because another 4 days they are working. So this happens. Equation modifies, so this is the amount of work done. Then the rest of the work is done by c alone, which is c into x. We don't know the number of days. We don't know the number of days. That should be equal to 1. You will get 3 times of a plus b is 1 by 10, 3 by 10, plus a and b can finish in 10 days. 7 times of b plus c, 7 into 1 by 15, plus 3 times c plus a, 3 into 1 by 20, plus cx plus c is equal to 1. So if you solve, you get here 60, 3 into 6, 18, plus 7 into 4, 28, plus 3 into 3, 9, so 28 plus 18, okay, 28 plus 18 is 46, 46 plus 9, so we get 55, 55, so c is 1 minus 55 by 60, so c is 1 by 12, is another way to do it. Just don't multiply by 6. If you multiply by 6, it will be counted as 12 days of work, because A and B are, A and C are repeating in two places. So I would love to know how you found this advanced set. If you want us to do more problems like this, because the simple problems are not what will get you in those institutes and in those companies. This advanced set is particularly challenging. If you want more such advanced sets, visit our website www.7sensetalent.com. If you've liked our effort looking at basic problems, intermediate problems, advanced problems, if you liked the effort, I suggest and request rather to visit our channel regularly, like it, subscribe, click on the bell icon so that you don't miss on videos, tell it to your friends so that they too benefit. And like we said, if you could visit our website 7sensetalent.com, you would get more advanced problems so that you can master profit and loss. Thank you for your love and attention, and we hope to see you soon once again.